How did Travis Fimmel land the role of a lifetime without an audition? Why did Neve Alger's love of cardio endear her to Ridley Scott? And how challenging was it for the actors to wear skin-tight latex? Hi, I'm Dylan, and you're watching ASA. Travis Fimmel as Marcus. This Australian actor has admitted that he loves to play flawed characters, so it's no surprise that he accepted the challenge of an Inception-like double role of a rebel soldier who undergoes plastic surgery to literally take someone else's place on a ship escaping a warring planet. And if you're thinking that this sounds like a crazy storyline, you're not alone. Fimmel himself has said, "I haven't really read anything at all that comes close to the world that's being created here. I think people will be really surprised, and they'll be like, I've never seen anything like this before, especially on TV." So just how did the former farmer prepare for his role? Technically, he didn't. Since wrapping up with Vikings, the actor has been vocal about his plans to retire from acting and live out his days on a farm in the outback, and if not for Ridley Scott, we may never have seen Fimmel in another television series. Although the actor has admitted that he is terrible at auditioning, he managed to dodge that bullet this time around. In an interview with Collider, he explained, "Fortunately enough, I didn't have to audition for this. I met with Ridley and I already knew my answer. I had to convince Ridley that he should hire me. I must have got him on a good day." So what about the role caught Fimmel's eye? Apart from jokingly admitting, "What brought me back was I needed money," the real appeal lay in the show's director. The actor explains, "It was all about Ridley. I signed on without even reading the script. What excited me the most, and I keep saying it, was Ridley Scott. But that wasn't the only appeal. He also likes a challenge. I always want a character who's flawed as can possibly be and has a lot to overcome. This character's got a great journey. I enjoyed exploring all of his flaws." In order to become Marcus, Fimmel not only abandoned his normal accent and added some makeup and a mullet, but he started writing. The actor admits that not only are his scripts full of scribbled thoughts, but he keeps a diary to get into the right headspace for Marcus. Fimmel has admitted that he's proud of his work on the show, and he's enjoyed every second. Well, almost every second. When asked if there was anything about the role he disliked, he admitted, "I don't love the action stuff at all. I'm lazy. I don't need to be a hero. I'm happy for the stunt guys to get paid to do their thing." We're behind you on that one, Travis. Neve Alger as Sue. This Irish actress, who is naturally blonde with a love of pastel colors, underwent quite the transformation to play the badass medic created by Ridley Scott. Alger is one of five children, and originally had no plans to act. She studied design in Dublin, and discovered acting when she covered stage design in her course. Last year, she was named as one of BAFTA's Breakthrough Brits, and prior to Raised by Wolves, she had smaller roles in mainly British productions. So when the chance to work with Ridley Scott presented itself, she couldn't resist. Like Fimmel, Alger is a fan of Scott's, and when asked what drew her to the script, she explained, "Ridley Scott's name was on the script, so I said yes. When I was on set, I just couldn't stop smiling, and my character is meant to be this real badass and absolute rebel." But apart from the opportunity to work with her idol, the actress found the role incredibly compelling and a fun challenge, partly because it was also physically demanding. In fact, it was partly a result of her unusual and sweaty audition that she got the part at all. The actress explained, "I auditioned by sending in a tape of me boxing. I do a bit of boxing anyway, and the physicality of my character Sue is athletic. But in the audition scenes, there wasn't anything to showcase that strength, and I really wanted to put that in." Not only was Scott impressed with her prowess, but as a boxer himself, he found he had a lot in common with Alger. She elaborates, "We ended up bonding over boxing as we had the same coach. Ridley is ridiculously in shape for a man who's in his 80s. I don't know how he does it." So what did the Irish beauty think of her role? "I think that the world that the writers and directors have created is unlike anything that I've seen on TV before." Alger has admitted that she loved playing Sue, who she calls a rebel without a cause. In fact, she managed to bring the role to life by finding similarities between herself and her character. In an interview with Screen Rant, she explained, "For me, it's figuring out what drives them, what their passions are, and what their fears are. And I think that when you start there, you can kind of build upon that." Whatever her process, she definitely did a stellar job. Wynta McGrath as Campion. Travis Fimmel isn't the only Aussie actor on the show. Wynta, who plays 12-year-old Campion, also hails from Down Under. The 15-year-old may play the sole surviving child gifted to the androids, but off-screen, he has two older brothers who are also actors. Despite landing the role at just 13, it's not McGrath's first foray into the acting world. His debut role came in 2014 alongside Jennifer Connelly in Aloft, before he appeared in the Australian series Doctor Doctor, along with a few other small movie roles. Although Raised by Wolves earned him international recognition, he's an average teenage boy. When he isn't hanging out with his co-stars, he enjoys playing tennis and making videos for his YouTube channel. Sadly, other details about his private life are limited. And though we have no doubt we'll be seeing more of this young actor in the future, we're hoping it won't just be limited to the second season of Raised by Wolves. Amanda Collin as Mother. Despite its focus on science fiction, Raised by Wolves' appeal lies in the ability of the androids to complete their mission. Before appearing as Mother, 34-year-old Danish actress Amanda Collin had never been in an international production. In fact, she was offered the role after casting director Kate Rhodes James saw her featured at the 2018 Subtitles Film Festival. When she thinks back to the audition, the actress explains that everything happened so quickly that she didn't have any time for self-doubt. She just had to learn her lines and deliver. And she's likely pretty pleased, because it's proven to be the role of a lifetime. Collin said, "There's no way I could have predicted what a gift this part is. I'm so happy, proud, fortunate, lucky to be able to give Mother a voice. I just think it's such an incredible and special gift in my life, really." To prepare for the role of the android, the actress cut off all her hair and started quite the exercise regimen. In fact, the actress admits, "I was working out a lot to build muscle and not look so stick-like. That's just my body. Obviously, the latex flattens out the little boobs that I have, but I feel very feminine in the role of Mother." However, playing Mother has also been challenging, and Collin worried that she was being too, well, human. In an interview with Collider, she explained, "The only thing I was worried about was, like, I kept saying, I spill it all, I'm too emotional." Despite this, there's no denying that she gave an impressive performance, and when asked how she channeled her inner android, she simply admitted, "That's acting, dude." Even though it was a physically demanding role in an uncomfortable costume with the nasty habit of causing her to sweat profusely, Collin has admitted that she wouldn't change a thing. She told Collider, "If I could do this show for the rest of my life, I would be so happy." Luckily, she's had the support of her husband and daughter for the transformation, and we can't wait to see what's next for Mother in the second season. Abubakar Salim as Father. If Mother was the quintessential caregiver and protector, then Father served as comic relief, complete with bad dad jokes. Yet, even with this human quirk, it's not easy to forget that he's an android, not least because of the blue eyes, red hair and latex suit, and robot movements. So how did the Kenyan-British actor, who's actually quite the lover of fashion, find himself playing Father? Salim describes his character's struggle as not only discovering what it means to feel and what it means to be himself, but discovering what his place is in regards to this new world. Salim decided to try acting when he was 16, and like Amanda Collin, is a BAFTA British Breakthrough Award recipient. Prior to working with Ridley Scott, he'd appeared in a few smaller roles, and knew he'd found a winner when he first read the script for Raised by Wolves. He recalls, "I remember reading the script and thinking this is something that is never going to go to someone like me." Thankfully, he was wrong, and 6 rounds of auditions later, he landed the role, and the rest is history. To prepare for the role, Salim immersed himself in the world of gaming. He explained, "I'm a massive nerd. I watch a lot of sci-fi. I play a lot of video games. That's my jam. So when it comes to influences and pieces of work, a lot of it comes from games and gaming." And though he had the perfect inspiration, he was still intimidated to work on the show, which was made even more challenging by the costume he had to wear. According to the actor, it was definitely a challenge. "The thing is, these latex suits were tailor-made. They measure you out, then squeeze you in it. You cover yourself in talcum powder and lube. I did at times feel like a giant condom. It was definitely a difficult costume to wear." But despite the discomfort, Salim has thoroughly enjoyed the role, from working with his co-stars and Ridley Scott to the dad jokes that he cracks at regular intervals. For this actor, playing Father meant an exciting opportunity that has left him feeling inspired. In an interview with Black Film and TV, he explained that Raised by Wolves has allowed him to think that he can do anything. He elaborated, "It's really given me this feeling of confidence in myself, and it's also just humbled me in that, yes, I've worked on this incredible show with incredible people. I'm still pinching myself every now and then. Honestly, I love it." And though we're excited to see more of this talented actor, he's also spending time in front of the screen. Salim told Anthem Magazine that, "I just opened a game studio in quarantine and I'm making my first game at the moment. I'm designing my first game, working with a team of people to create this story world and build this universe. Watch this space." Whose transformation did you think was most impressive? Let us know in the comments, and until next time, stay awesome!